We've been asked by many, what gets cooked at home? Ghoti food or Bangal food?
Welcome to Cook with Pichandama. Today, we are going to cook a perfect Ilish Mach Bhaja. Though, there is nothing Ghoti or Bangal about it.
It's just the story of our kitchen. Wait till the end to find out what it is. I have two beautiful pink Hilsa steaks with some roe in it, so which we call Ilish Mach Hadeem, and this fish is 1.3 kilos in weight. I never buy a fish which is less than 1.2 kilos, even 1 kilo I don't. I prefer buying 1.2 kilos and more. So what we are going to do is marinate that with a little bit of salt and about half a teaspoon of turmeric powder. And you rub the salt and the turmeric powder over the fish, all over the fish. You can take the roe out and rub the roe, or you can keep it intact also, it's up to you. So rub it beautifully all over the fish. It's a small request. Don't buy baby Ilish. You know, even the ones that you get in the market for 300, 400 grams, don't buy them. You are just going to, be responsible for the extinction of Ilish. Take a frying pan or a skillet and heat 2 to 3 tablespoons of mustard oil to fry the fish. And while the oil is heating, let me tell you a story. So I grew up eating Ilish Mach Bhaja with the Ilish Mach Tel and just one dried red chili, which you would be deep fried in the same Ilish Mach Tel, and that would be crumbled with rice and salt, and that's it. Let the oil almost reach a smoking point, and that's when you gently slide the Hilsa steaks into the frying pan and also add the roe in the same oil. Keep the heat at a medium and let them gently fry. Oh, the smell of Hilsa frying, it's so good that even your neighbors will come to know that you're frying Hilsa. Flip the roe will get cooked faster. So flip it when one side is cooked, and same with the fish, when one side is golden and crispy, flip it and let both sides of the fish cook equally. So you don't have to fry it too much, just a little bit of crispy coating and let the fish remain nice and soft inside. That's when you drain it out of the oil and keep it aside. Look what a beautiful, gorgeous color it has got. Now in the same hot oil, add a couple of dried red chilies and just brown it. Don't burn it, just brown it till it's puffed up and crispy, and then take it out and keep it with the Ilish Mach. And then comes the liquid gold. Pour it out in a bowl and let it cool down. When it comes to cooking Ilish at home, we try to stick to the classics, the 5 or 6 different varieties of classics, and we don't like to experiment much with this beautiful, gorgeous fish.
So for me, while growing up, we used to have Ilish Mach Tel, Alu Bhate was must, and green chilies. Now I have written somewhere in my blog also that Baba used to take great care in making those perfect ball-sized, ball-shaped Alu Bhate, and we never used to have Ilish Mach Bhaja or a dried red chili fry with the first course. If you ever get into a discussion of Bangal and Ghoti and which one is supreme, you must have heard a term called Bati. And that's what exactly happens in our home right now.
It's nothing but an amalgamation of two kitchens. So what we do now is we have Ilish Mach Bhaja with the oil, but we have it with Alu Sheto or mashed potatoes and red chilies, not green chilies. So, it's a win-win for all, and we all enjoy it.
There it is, a plate full of rice, the fried fish roe, the fried fish, there's the crispy red chili, and then you drizzle some of that fish oil on the rice. Rake the red chili, crumble it on the rice with the oil. Take your mashed potato, mix it all up, and there are very few things which is as good as this. So if you like this recipe, do leave in a comment below and subscribe to our channel. Share this with your friends and your family.